to. Breakaway. Shorthanded. Scores. Second shorthanded goal we've seen tonight. It is 4-1. That is Cassian, who was hurt behind the play.
Zach Cassian just... you could see there, just kind of gets caught up with TJ Brody, who's trying to keep the puck in, and then it just goes the other way, and Mike Smith tries to get as big as possible, but Mark Letestu, who had all day, he just kind of coasts in and puts it right over the left pad of Mike Smith. And Matt Benning, a big part of this big kill for the Edmonton Oilers. That's the first shot block, and then on the other side, he blocks another one, Johnny Gaudreau, and you can see Zach Cassian going right to the dressing room.
Net to shoot at. Final 10 seconds of the penalty to Stoner. Here's a short hand of it for Cogliano. He's in. Score! But this time, the Wild defense gets overly aggressive in a situation where no one had clear possession of the puck. Battle along the boards, Cam Fowler trying to chip it out once, and then the second time he spots Cogliano, who will float in the zone in on the breakaway. His first of the season is an enormous goal for the Ducks. They strike shorthanded, and this game is tied.
Sixth career shorthanded goal as a Duck for Andrew Cogliano, who last season had three of them.
Best power play in the league, by the way, belongs to the Pittsburgh Penguins. But here's Grabner, and he scores! Shorthanded goal! And the Islanders tie it 1-1 as Grabner rediscovers his Olympic form.
Well, the Islanders have had all kinds of opportunities. We talked about Bolton having a couple of chances. Up he played by the Maple Leafs in the neutral zone. Grabner just stays on the Toronto Maple Leaf, and short side shot there as he's able to steal the puck really from Gardner, who's a little lax in his own zone, and Bernier has no opportunity to get himself ready, and the Islanders cash in on a nice shorthanded opportunity.
McDonald clears out. 7 seconds remain to Bolton's penalty. And a giveaway, they score! Grabner again! Miscommunication between the defenseman Riley and the goaltender Bernier. It's Grabner 2, Toronto 1. It will be his second shorthanded goal on the same penalty kill.
Chris puts pressure on Riley, and that's just a terrible play by Bernier. I mean, I don't know what he's thinking. He's coming out. You got to make your decision quicker than that. And Bernier just gives the puck up. Riley has no opportunity, and Grabner just stops in front of the net, and that's the key. He didn't turn away, kept his eyes on the puck.
Brent Burns for Pavelski, and he lost control of the puck, and look out, here's a shorthanded breakaway. Cassian stepping in, scores!
What a huge goal for Zach Cassian. Great job by him and Patrick Maroon in the box. You love to see this when you're waiting for the guys hoping to kill off a penalty. Good penalty killing with the stick. He takes off, receives it, and just a quick snapshot beats Jones for a 1-0 lead. Cassian's been physical, he's been aggressive, and it pays off with a good chance on the penalty kill. This is an area he's really improved at.
He's from Barzell, out for Boychuk, over to Hosang. Trying to feed it back to Boychuk, it came to Kopitar instead. Kopitar has help coming in Doughty. Kopitar to Doughty, and he scores! It's a shorthanded goal for the LA Kings. They lead 3-1.
Talk about a veteran play. Got Hosang to think that that pass was open and then stepped in front of the Hosang pass to Johnny Boychuk. A very, very tough pass to make, and then Kopitar waiting for Kempe. Watch the pass right through the legs of Johnny Boychuk. It just doesn't get any better than that. Captain of the hockey team makes an absolutely pitcher pass. Tremendous play to Doughty.
P.K. Subban into the Penguin zone. Lost control. Sutter takes it away. Brandon Sutter in on Boudin with a backhand. He scores! Brandon Sutter with a shorthanded goal. Burns the Canadians again.
Well, I got to tell you, Michael Therrien is steaming right now, and rightfully so. Subban was tired. I think a timeout might have been appropriate. Dumping the puck in would have been more appropriate by Subban, who was absolutely exhausted. And what a goal by Sutter. Picks the pocket. It was a delayed penalty. You see the referee's arm up. Goes to the backhand, elevates the puck. Sutter with another big goal against the Montreal Canadiens. We remember what Sutter did last year.
Oilers, they lead it 1-0. Justin Schultz will drop one along for Everly. And now fast and loose with the puck. Here's Reeder shorthanded. He's in. And he scores. First shorthanded goal. And what a lift. Toby Reeder has tied it in Edmonton.
Over here, Taylor Hall coughs it up on the blue line. And Reeder opens up the five hole on Foss. What a beautiful play. Rumbling down that right side. Little shake and bake, opens it up and puts it in the back of the net. That's a big goal.
Now to Keaton with a shot. Blocked away that time by Hansel, and he'll skate it out.
There goes Reeder again.
And he's coming back in again. Reeder to the net. He scores! And another shorthanded goal. Toby Reeder. Second shorthanded goal of the night. The Coyotes lead it 2-1.
And it's the same kid. I'm telling you, this kid is something else. Look at the speed. He wanted this puck too, and Hansel puts it right on a string for him. And you knew Faust was thinking about this one. Is he gonna go back with the same move? And he doesn't. He's got another one in his hat, in his bag of tricks. He goes far side, I believe, posted in off the right shoulder and into the back of the net. Talk about a change of momentum.
Two shorties by Toby Reeder in the span of 58 seconds.
You're lucky you get two in your career, let alone in the same shift.